want to talk about this device that I bought from Daiso. It is a $2 power bank that runs on 2 AA batteries. I found this power bank rather special because normally when we get a power bank, it has a built-in lithium-ion battery already inside, and this allows me to change the batteries whenever the batteries are depleted instead of having to find a power source to charge it back up again. However, this advantage also comes with its own limitation. There's a reason why such power banks are less popular these days, and that is because the batteries that is used to power these sort of power banks are usually inferior to lithium-ion or lithium-polymer batteries that we see in typical power banks these days. At the back of the package, it says that there is a limit of 1 ampere that it can put out, but I suspect that this might not be possible depending on what sort of batteries that you put in. It is also estimated that it will only charge up to 30% for an iPhone on a pair of batteries. Overall, this is likely to be a very poor choice if you are using this power bank to charge a phone. To make things worse, this power bank is so simple that it doesn't even have a switch. The moment you put in the batteries, it starts consuming energy from the batteries. This means that if you are not careful and you have left a pair of batteries inside the power bank, you are likely to find it drained by the time you want to use it again. At this point, you may be wondering whether is it even useful to buy a power bank like this in this day and age. And yet, there are still advantages in using such a simple power bank if you are doing things like charging a small wireless headphone that uses very little current. And that is because most other power banks would typically shut down after a while if it senses that the current draw is too small. Having said that, there are some power banks that allow the user to keep the power bank turned on for several hours to charge such devices. But what if you need even longer hours than that? This is where the power bank shines. Because let's say if you are powering up a small microcontroller project that you need to run for the entire day or until the battery runs out, then this one will allow you to do so. As far as I have tested, it continuously powers on until the batteries are completely drained. Now, as you can see, the power consumption of my microcontroller project is only about 40 milliamperes. This small amount would definitely cause a normal power bank to shut down, as it would assume that whatever it is charging is already full. I am also quite happy with the fact that it manages to hold the voltage at a good 5 volts, 5.01 to be exact. It is definitely suitable and stable enough to be used for small consumption projects. For this case, this is a DigiSpark microcontroller that is connected to a DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor and a LCD screen. Last but not least, while making this video, I realized that the inner battery slot is actually very tight and I have to pry out the battery with a small screwdriver. This dented the negative terminal of the battery, and I suspect it is due to the middle separator that is inside the battery compartment. But for $2, I can't complain much. Perhaps trimming away the middle separator would help. And that is about all I have to say about this power bank. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them below. Thank you for watching. Bye!